everybody. This is Jen. Welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you 10 tips on how to be successful with winter sewing. That's right here on Garden Jen's Journey. Okay, so today we're talking about 10 ways that you can be more successful with winter sewing. If you don't know what winter sewing is, check out my video and it explains in depth what winter sewing is. Today I'm going to share with you some tips. So it's going to be just some pointers on making sure that when you do it, you're successful. Now, I've been doing winter sewing for approximately 6 years. This will be my 7th year. And so I'm quite experienced in what works and what doesn't work. I also am learning as I go on some ways to change things up a little bit so I have even more success. So today let's talk about those 10 tips. Number one, you want to make sure that you use milk jugs, juice jugs, things that are about that size, this size here. You want this size jug to achieve the most success. And you want to make sure they're translucent. These are miniature greenhouses. So when you look for containers to do winter sewing in, think about a greenhouse. A greenhouse is translucent. It's see-through. That way the sun can get in and warm up the soil, warm up the seedlings, and the seedlings can process the photosynthesis. So don't use big, large bins, and I'll share a video up above of why I suggest not to use bins, but use a container about this size, and you'll have the most success, and make sure they're not the white, opaque ones that won't allow the sun in. So that's tip number one, very important for success. Tip number two, when it comes to what you're going to put in it for the seeds to grow, you want good quality potting soil. You do not want seed starting mix. You don't want potting soil that has added fertilizers or added components that help increase the water retention. These seedlings are going to be sitting in these jugs for quite a long time, almost completely undisturbed, and we want to make sure that number one, we're not having additional fertilizer, which makes them grow too fast, and number two, that we're not having water absorption problems that keep too much water in the container. So no additional additives to your potting soil. Just make sure it's a good quality loose potting soil. Do not use a seed starting mix. There is not enough nutrients for long term. Number three, do not use cardboard like toilet paper rolls or tubes like that, peat pellets, peat pots, cell pack containers to try to separate your seedlings within the jug. It's actually more detrimental. If you know about cardboard, when it's wet and it sits around for a while in the damp environment, it molds, and you do not want mold in your jugs with those seedlings. You also really don't want all those chemicals that are in the paper products. So don't use those paper products. Don't use the peat pellets. The peat is not enough nutrition for seedlings to be growing in it long term. Peat pellets are a great way to start seedlings if you're growing them indoors and then up potting them to regular potting soil. But in winter sowing, we're not up potting. Those seedlings stay in those jugs until transplant time. I'll share a video above, a link on how easy it is to transplant seedlings out of the jugs. Now the video showcases some of the smaller seedlings that I deal with. I will be updating with some of the larger seedlings like tomatoes and things like that later on this year. But they all transplant just fine. The biggest thing is to make sure that when you go to transplant, you water your jug thoroughly so the soil is moist and it comes apart very easy. So don't try to pre-separate your seedlings by putting those other items in the jug. It just creates more of a hassle for you. All right, number four. We want to make sure that when we're planting in our jugs that we use labels. We recommend that you put a label on the inside of the jug and also right on the outside. That way you have a backup in case one or the other labels wears off. I've been a part of a winter sowing group for a long time, and there's been countless times that people are trying to get other people to help identify their plants because their tags have worn off and they have no idea what is growing in their jugs. So try to use at least two labels and make sure you notate in a log or a journal of what you plant in your jugs so you're not trying to figure it out when it's time to plant. Next, you want to make sure when marking those labels that you use a paint pen. We use acrylic paint pens. I buy the ones from Walmart, Joann's. I can even get them online. They're the Elmer's brand. But any acrylic paint pen will work. You do not want to use a Sharpie or a permanent marker. Those do wear off in time because your jugs are outside for almost 5 to 6 months and the constant sun beating down on them does fade those markers. So highly recommend using a paint pen. Next, you want to make sure that you water your seeds thoroughly when you go to plant them. You don't want your soil to be a sopping mess because we don't want to trap all that water in there when it freezes. But you want them to have a good amount of moisture. That way when it starts thawing out, the plant has the water it needs to start growing. If it comes time that you notice that your jugs are starting to dry out as the seedlings are getting ready to grow, you can easily gently mist or pour some gentle water in through the top of your jugs. Or another way that a lot of people do it is they'll take some trays. They'll take some trays like this. I also use, I have a lot of flats because I have a landscaping company, and just set them in the trays and fill the trays with about an inch of water when the jugs are in there. Fill them about with an inch of water and let the jugs draw the moisture up from the trays and then remove the jugs back out of there. That's a good way to promote root development because the roots are going to go down searching for that water instead of staying shallow if you keep watering in through the top. So water your seeds good in the beginning, and then if they start to dry out later on in your season, just carefully water them and you'll be just fine. Another tip that's very important is you want to make sure when you tape your jugs, you do a good job doing it. Again, we're trying to create miniature greenhouses, and to do that effectively, we need to make sure that our jugs are sealed. That way, the heat and the moisture stay around those plants and help them grow. So I always recommend a good quality duct tape. Some people have used painter's tape and that's worked okay. Some people use dollar store duct tape. I use Gorilla tape. That works very well. I do not recommend shipping tape, packaging tape. That doesn't do so well because we are going to have a moist environment that gets kind of warm. This is going to be out in the elements, so it's going to get wet. And packaging tape, once it gets wet, it doesn't hold very well. Speaking of not holding very well, If you've done everything you can to make sure that when you put your jugs together and put them outside, that you've taped them really well, made sure that the jug was dry and debris free, and really pressed that tape on there, and it's looking really good and you can pick it up when you go put it outside. But then later on things happen and you notice that the tape lets go. It's what I call tape failure. And we do run into that. Sometimes the adhesive isn't as strong, or something just happens and the tape lets go and you end up with gaps in your jug because the tape is not holding. I have had that happen. I will post a link to a video above about tape failure and the simple remedy you can do to fix that. And basically the simple remedy is just to retape it when the weather is warm. It's hard to retape the jugs when it's still cold outside because the adhesive does not stick when it's cold, but when it gets warmer you can retape them. Something really important to take note of, especially with the way the weather has been fluctuating lately, is if you have a warm spell, like a really, really warm spell, and your cold sensitive plants start germinating and you're still expecting freezing weather, make sure that you have blankets available to be able to cover your jugs at night, before night. That way you're protecting them from the freezing weather, and most of the time it works pretty good. Do not ever, ever, ever take your jugs indoors if you're expecting freezing temperatures. The drastic change in temperature from being outside in the cold to going into a warm environment can really be disastrous for your seedlings. Never take them indoors. If you feel that you need to protect your seedlings more than just a cover, you can put them inside a unheated garage if you'd like, a shed, something like that. Sometimes I will bring mine into the greenhouse depending on how cold it's going to get. But generally, just covering the seedlings with that cloth will help. And then when the sun is up in the morning, uncover them. That way they can get the sun to continue to warm that jug and get the air circulation. But that again is only if your cold sensitive crops have germinated too early. If crops like spinach and kale and onions and things that like the cold weather germinate, let them be. Unless you're getting like in the negative temperatures, then go ahead and throw a cover on them and make sure to remove it in the morning. Another question that often gets asked is, when do I open my jugs? You want to leave your jugs closed as long as possible to keep that greenhouse effect so the plants grow as big and healthy as possible. Sometimes it's really tempting to open that jug because you think your seedlings are big enough, but you're actually ruining the greenhouse effect that makes those plants so hardy. So our recommendation is that you leave the jugs closed as long as possible. If you're in a really warm zone where you're having temperatures in the 80s, 90s, and above, then of course we say go ahead and vent those jugs. Otherwise, you know, you're going to be cooking your plants. And move those jugs into a shady area as well to protect them from that direct sun. But generally, unless the plants are growing through the top of the jugs, and some will do that, you want to leave them closed until about a day or two before you go to plant them. And then you're going to open them up and just allow the seedlings to be used to the direct sun and the wind and things like that. It's a lot less involved than when you have to harden your seedlings when they're grown inside, but still you got to get your seedlings used to the direct sun and wind without a covering over the top. Last but not least, you want to have patience with this process. When you're growing seeds in these jugs outside, You're letting nature take control rather than you. A lot of seedlings, especially your warm, loving crops, might seem behind from when you can purchase them at a nursery. You have to remember, when you purchase them at a nursery, they've been grown indoors in large greenhouses, so they've kind of been forced to grow before their time. Outdoors, they're not going to grow until the temperature is right for them. But once the temperature is right, they're going to start germinating, start growing, and they're going to grow really well in their miniature greenhouses. In the northern zones especially, your nightshade plants, the ones that really love tropical heat temperatures, they're going to sprout last. And so you're going to be freaking out because you don't have any tomatoes or peppers or eggplants to plant when other people might be grabbing them from the store and planting. But don't worry, they will start to grow, they will catch up, and they will actually outperform those plants that you buy from the nursery. This has been proven over and over again, I would say at least 90% of the time. So you have to practice patience with those crops. With your nightshade vegetables, you want to make sure that you're planting them when the ground is warm anyways. So a lot of people try to jumpstart and get them in the ground really early, and that actually stunts the plants. Sure, you've got your garden planted, but you're actually doing more harm to the plants by planting them in the ground too early. So wait until those seeds start germinating and growing and get a nice size like you would buy when you go to the store or nursery, and then go ahead and plant them in the ground. By the time that they are big and coming out of the top of those jugs, your ground should be warm enough that they're really going to thank you for waiting. Here in Zone 5B, generally my tomatoes and peppers don't start growing until late May, early June. And a lot of people in my area are trying to put them in the ground in June. We tend to have frost until June. So that means that the ground is still quite cold anyways, because the temperatures haven't stayed really warm enough to get that soil temperature warm. So it's best to wait. I don't plant my tomatoes generally until almost July. And they do very well, because by then the soil is warm enough where it doesn't stunt their growth. So patience, patience, patience. And just enjoy the whole process if it's brand new, and trust the process. It does work, especially if you follow the guidelines that I've kind of given in my how-to winter sow video and these tips I'm sharing with you today. And if you have any problems or any questions, feel free to comment in the comment box below. Shoot me an email. I do have my email address listed on my channel. I'd be more than happy to discuss winter sowing with you. And I'll be doing more videos this year about how I personally do it and the results that I personally get from it, so you guys can see how this process works in real time. So until next time, everybody, I thank you so much for watching my video. I hope that you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't, please subscribe to the channel. I'd love to have you along on my journey. And I hope that wherever you are wonderfully blessed. Bye-bye.